Hi, I'm Zach.
And I'm Karen. Welcome to another awesome video in our Control Cabinet Classroom series.
Today, we're covering different sources of transients, more specifically, lightning electromagnetic pulses, switching electromagnetic pulses, and electrostatic discharge. Now, I know that sounds like a lot of big and scary phrases, but don't worry, it's just lightning, switches, and static.
First, let's define what a transient is. Transients are simply extra voltages that are transferred or coupled onto a power circuit. One type of transient, lightning, is easy to see and understand.
Obviously, if your facility or something close to your facility gets hit by a lightning strike, bad things tend to happen. This is because lightning has a ton of energy behind it. That energy comes with a lot of current and voltage. When that much energy gets coupled onto your system, the resulting damage is extreme.
Luckily, direct lightning strikes are fairly rare occurrences in the transient world. What you commonly see, hundreds to thousands of times a day, are switching electromagnetic pulses.
Every time something is switched from on to off, or vice versa, a little transient spike is generated. Whenever you switch your lights on or start your car, these pulses are created. Now imagine an industrial facility with hundreds of machines running throughout the day, cycling on and off, each time creating its own spike. These transient spikes may not cause damage right away, but over time, unprotected equipment will get damaged.
Finally, there's electrostatic discharge, or ESD. For this, we're going to set up a little demo for you. All right, we're all set. Everyone knows what static discharge feels like. You walk around on a dry day and you get shocked whenever you touch someone. Don't touch me, Zach. Just in case you live under a rock, though, we happen to have an ESD generator here.
So, Karen, if you will, I know you're a little nervous. Put your hand on the Van de Graaff machine. Okay, and as the static builds up,
I don't get paid enough for this.
Karen's hair should do something different. Are you ready, Karen?
Sure.
Okay, let's see how it goes. There you go. It's starting. Okay, I'm gonna turn it off for you, Karen. Don't let go. There we go. Ouch. So even though static is usually just a nuisance, it can cause problems if you're using extremely sensitive equipment. In a typical factory, this could be an area where printed circuit boards are being populated. Or if you're in a hazardous area where flammable or explosive gas is present, a spark created by ESD can actually cause an explosion or a fire.
You can take steps to prevent ESD by using protective equipment like shoe straps and jackets, like these shown here. Additionally, there are surge protection devices, or SPDs, that are used within industrial control cabinets and applications that help prevent any kind of transient from damaging your equipment. We'll cover SPDs in depth in a future episode.
If you're shocked by this video, please give us a big old thumbs up before you click onto something else, and be sure to subscribe so you get all our new videos as they're released. See you next time.